So I think that Krillin is starting to suspect something.
Prepare yourself, Din Sien.
Subscribe and hit the notification bell to help us achieve the 300k mortal plan. Every soul counts. We are back with another new chapter to Bulma Falls in Love with Vegeta on Planet Namek. This is the original Dragon Ball fan manga by Queen of Fangs on Twitter. I'm gonna leave a link to her Twitter account in the description below in the top comment. Go ahead, check her out. Always support the creator. And if you're not all caught up on this story, I'm gonna leave a full playlist again in the description and the top comment. That way you guys can go ahead, get caught up before you watch this video, or watch this video and catch back up after. Last time on Bulma x Vegeta on Namek, Bulma pulls out a space rifle and starts unloading on Captain Ginyu so that way he cannot change his body into Vegeta's, ultimately saving Vegeta and letting the events of the normal anime conclude where we get Ginyu Frog. And now we play the waiting game as they wait for Goku to heal up in the chamber so he can be 100% for the fight against Frieza. Let's continue. Krillin states the obvious and says that he's surprised that Vegeta is helping them and that he's essentially taking care of Bulma. And Bulma says, well, Son asked him to help and take care of her so that way she would be safe. If you guys remember, that's not what happened at all, and Bulma essentially just lied to her own friends for Vegeta, the villain of this story, or one of the villains of this story. So why did Bulma do this? Why is she lying for Vegeta? It is quite simple. Bulma reciprocates her feelings for Vegeta as well, and I think that she has fallen in love with him, as this little white lie has shown us. Even Vegeta is looking at her like, what are you talking about, woman? So right now the story has built up their relationship in an organic and normal way, and it doesn't feel rushed. It doesn't feel like they're just there. It feels like there has been a lot of tension with these two, and now they're at a place where Bulma would even lie to her own friends about what Vegeta did, which is essentially kidnap her. But Bulma wants him to be part of the crew, so she lied for him, and I definitely like the way this chapter is starting out. Krillin looks around in awe of the technology in Frieza's ship. This is an alien spaceship, so he should be in awe. I mean, we kind of just glance over the fact that this is an alien high-tech spaceship in the anime and the manga. I like that they're taking the time to have the Earthling's mind being blown as to what is possible in this spaceship. But as Vegeta is getting armor for the other two, Krillin looks on the ground and sees and finally realizes, notices that Bulma's original clothing is on the ground, and Bulma is wearing just her jacket but with Saiyan armor as well. So she had to have gotten undressed in this room as well as Vegeta. So the big mystery of the last chapter is, why was there like a normal looking alien rifle inside Frieza's ship? And Bulma asked Vegeta that same thing, and that is something that was part of a game that Frieza played with the weaklings in his army. And essentially what would happen is that he would hide random weapons around the ship, and the ones that were smart enough, crafty enough to find the weapons stayed in the army. But if you did not find these weapons, if you did not care enough or search adequately, then Frieza would execute you. And that's just a reminder to the other two as to who they're actually facing, who they're fighting against. But it also shows that Bulma is crafty enough to be in Frieza's army because she was the one that found the rifle. Now that the whole squad is all geared up, Krillin decides that it is time to go and find the password to call the dragon. So he's gonna go to Guru's place, and hopefully Frieza's not there. In the anime, he was there and he does fight Nail, but then Nail kind of holds him still for a while and keeps him busy to buy everyone time. So he's going to find the password, and Bulma wishes him luck. But before Krillin leaves, he wants to ask Bulma something, but then decides that no, he's just crazy. His mind is playing tricks on him, and he doesn't think that there's anything going on between these two, and it kind of looks like they're together, like as they're standing side by side. And even Krillin probably feels like a tension between them. He probably feels something happened, something was going on, there's something there, and Krillin even senses it. But you know what, he's just has his mind in the clouds. He's thinking crazy thoughts because Vegeta killed her ex-boyfriend. Like, why would she fall in love with him? Why would there be anything between these two? So Bulma decides to go off into the ship and look for more technology, look for more research. And you can see here that she's got the rifle slung on her back, and it looks like an AK-47, like a space AK-47. Looks pretty dope. And Gohan asks Vegeta to help him look for the Dragon Balls, and Vegeta just kind of turns around and follows Bulma. And even Gohan feels like there's something weird going on, but he's like, you know what, adults are probably just weird. And this is the issue with what's going on with Vegeta's mentality right now, because he is, in this panel, shows that he is extremely 100% distracted by Bulma. He just followed her out of the room. I remember feeling this feeling towards Rose, that I was kind of like a puppy dog following her when we first started dating, because I was that infatuated. And it looks like Vegeta has the same thing for Bulma. So again, very good writing, very good storytelling in this, showing that Vegeta is losing sight of everything else and wants Bulma for himself. Bulma's ready to put this hour to good use while Goku heals and learn more about the ship, but Vegeta needs to talk to her about the fact that she lied about their situation. And Bulma says, it's just a little white lie, let's all get along in this situation. She knows that they stand a better chance together than apart, and Vegeta gives a very weak laugh and then falls backward and passes out. Remember, at this point in the anime, Vegeta does fall asleep in the ship waiting for Goku to regenerate, and that is when Gohan and Krillin are able to sneak off with the Dragon Balls. I always thought that was kind of strange. Like, you never see Vegeta falling asleep at the wheel at any other point in Dragon Ball Z, and so it was kind of out of character for him just to like go to sleep and not really pay attention to everything else that was going on. It was definitely something that Akira Toriyama used to move the plot along so Gohan and Krillin will take the Dragon Balls away. In this aspect, it's a lot more believable. He's exhausted, he followed Bulma out of the other room, so Bulma was the actual distraction, but he passes out because he is tired. So I definitely like the way that this did it a lot better than the master Akira Toriyama. As Vegeta sleeps, Bulma crouches down and just kind of stares at him for a little bit, almost reaching out, trying to touch him, but pulls away again because she knows there's something there, but she's not ready to have it out in the open just yet. Which I also very much like, that this isn't just a one-sided thing from Vegeta to Bulma. Bulma also has a tremendous attraction to Vegeta. As Vegeta sleeps, Bulma is messing around with the ship, getting all sorts of technology that could push the story forward if this story continues past Namek, where Bulma takes all this technology back to Earth. And Vegeta wakes up, finding a blanket on him, but also finding error alarms everywhere. Bulma probably really went deep diving into the ship, but he realizes that everything is pitch black. Why is it so dark in here? He runs out asking what that noise is, why is it so dark, and sees Bulma grabbing her and asking her what's going on. And it looks like Bulma has been kind of fumbling in the dark, not knowing exactly what the hell is going on as well, but realizes that it's the sky that turned dark, not the ship. Vegeta looks out the window and sees that not only is the sky dark, but there is a huge monster outside. And this is all weird because there are multiple suns on the planet, and he's never seen the dragon being summoned, so he has no idea what this is until he realizes that no, this can't be. It is the dragon. And Bulma in the back, I think she realizes that Krillin must have been the one to summon the dragon behind Vegeta's back. And she even looks a little bit like she's guilty because she was with the Earthlings. She came with the Earthlings. And of course, that is when Vegeta starts blaming her for this, that she distracted him, it's her fault. Bulma reassures him that all she's been doing is trying to save everybody. She rescued him. She rescued him twice, actually, and then rescued her friends. So it's not actually her fault. And he can throw a huge temper tantrum if he wants, but there is no way that she is going to take the blame on this one. Vegeta doesn't have time for this, and that is when he realizes something that Bulma, who is not a key user, cannot. And that is that Frieza is almost here. If you remember this part in the anime, he is flying at the dragon at top speed. And he doesn't make it there before the dragon disintegrates because of Guru's death. But we'll see how this plays out in this Dragon Ball fan manga. Let's go ahead and check out the story tomorrow. Thank you so much for watching the video. Let's see who won. Hashtag end of video squad. The winner of today's hashtag end of video squad, the soul that decided to stay till the very end of my previous video and drop hashtag end of video squad on their comment, is going to be Slow Plays and Mondo Cool. I wanted to go ahead and do something very unconventional. These two guys, I know for a fact that they've watched the entire video. They are my boys, Slow Plays and Mondo Cool, probably the closest YouTubers that I have in the community. They have been exceptional friends and really looked out for me. And Slow Play says Bulma a badass, to be honest, absolutely, in this Dragon Ball fan manga. She is a gunslinger. She is awesome. She could handle herself against anyone. And Mondo Cool says probably the best thumbnail I've ever seen. And a little crown. Thank you so much, Mondo. That means a lot. Yes, it was kind of tough to work around the culture from the original art from the creator of this Dragon Ball fan manga to get it to be on a YouTube thumbnail, but I did, and it actually came out really well, especially with Ginyu Frog. Thank you so much for the compliments, guys. You guys are awesome. Make sure you subscribe to Slow Plays and Mondo Cool. Check out their channels, because one does amazing video game reviews and gameplay, and the other one is a fellow Dragon Ball fan manga reviewer. Thank you guys all for watching. This is going to be Blackscape signing off. Take care, guys.
Subscribe for more content. Perish.